We are seeing numismatic history being made. The Royal Mint has released the first portrait of King Charles III that will be used in circulating British coinage. It will be the first time since 1971 that citizens of the United Kingdom will get to see more than one monarch on their everyday coins. Before Decimal Day, one would be able to find coins from a whole bunch of monarchs, even very worn down coins of Queen Victoria, by that time dead for over 70 years on their change. But wait, stop for a minute. That's a channel about ancient coins. Why on earth are you analyzing a new release of a modern mint? And that is a fair question. I consider British coinage special among modern coins because it does have a series of traditions and conventions of what is to be shown on their coins that sadly a lot of other countries have abandoned in the last century or so. So the first circulating design of Charles III to be released will be the 50 pence. Okay, how about we go on a quick review of it? Let's see, maybe with an ancient collector's perspective, what the Royal Mint did, what they did well, and what they did not do well, and see what makes British coinage a little bit unique. Okay, out of the get-go, let's look at the obverse. The first thing that makes UK coins unique is that they keep a tradition of over 1,000 years of having their coins written in Latin. What is written has changed a little bit over the years, but in its current iteration, the formula for the coin is the name of the monarch, then Dei Gratia, or by the grace of God, Rex for king, or Regina for a queen, Fidei Defensor, defender of the faith, and then the denomination in pence, or pounds, which are also direct descendants of Latin words. Penny was the English name for the old Roman denarius, so much so that the abbreviation used in the pre-decimal coinage was a D instead of a P. And pounds comes from pondus, Latin for weight, as in a standard weight of silver. And here we have the first break in tradition, and my only real criticism for this new design. Charles has broken with the tradition of having his name given in Latin, which would be Carolus, Carolus Tertius. The reason given by the Royal Mint was that this allowed for the population to more easily recognize the monarch's name, as very few people can understand Latin, or even make the association that Carolus is nothing more than Charles in Latin. This, for me, is a horribly missed opportunity to raise awareness to the public of the things that make their coinage special. They have so very many things, traditions, places in the British Isles that are thousands of years old. It is part of their heritage, and to break this tradition for a simple utilitarian reason, for me, that's very tasteless. Yes, people would think Carolus might sound funny at first, but I'm pretty sure 99% of people are intelligent enough to think for a couple of seconds and realize this is Latin. You don't have to break with such a nice tradition for that. It is true that Elizabeth had it easy on that regard. Her name, as it was on coins, Elizabeth, is a valid name in Latin. Elizabeth is a very old name, but even centuries ago it was already very similar to what it's spelled out today. Examples being Queen Elizabeth I having the name Elizabeth, even with a TH, the exact same name on her coins. Even Isabel I, a late medieval Spanish monarch, had the name Elizabeth on her own pieces. You would have to go way back in time to the end of the 13th century to find a version of Elizabeth that looks remarkably different, Isabel with a Y and a double L. Okay, on to the portrait itself. Charles definitely played it safe with his choice, and I'd say it's all right. English monarchs have worn all kinds of headgear and clothing on coinage throughout the centuries, from crowns to laurel wreaths and clothing worthy of a Roman emperor. Considering the kind of scrutiny the monarchy is under, with sectors of the media and politics calling out Britain's imperialist colonial past, Charles opted for a plain bust, looking to the opposite direction of her mother's portrait, as per tradition. For centuries now, English kings are not depicted with the crown. So that's par for the course. It's not like him not wearing the crown was a deliberate decision. If we go a couple of centuries back and look at some other coinage, as for example this halfpenny of George III, we can see that he's shown wearing a laurel wreath and robes that make him look exactly like a Roman emperor, all the way to the small fibula on his shoulder. This portrait wouldn't look out of place in a coin of the 2nd century AD. Imagine the absolute mess it would be nowadays if Charles decided to be depicted like that. We then head to the reverse. I wish coinage from other countries would have this level of complexity and detail. Maybe this would stimulate more modern coin collectors. It doesn't really matter if you support monarchy, this is a beautiful and complex design, with the shields of England, Scotland, and Ireland, and the crown at the center. At a time of succession in the royal line, it makes sense to release a design that advocates the unity of all kingdoms under one crown and one national union. It is also a design that pays homage to the coinage of his late mother. It is a recreation of the design issued celebrating her coronation, which is very tasteful in my opinion. Could it have been a better release? Yes, in my humble opinion, the switch from the Latin name to the name in English among the rest of the traditional Latin legends, it's a bit tasteless and too utilitarian in my view. But hey, this might just be because I collect Roman coins and I love Latin legends on my coins. Other than that, I believe this is actually a pretty reasonable and good first design. The bust was tastefully made, the reverse has a beautiful design that connects this issue to the late queen's first issue. All in all, I think it was a good design. What do you think about King Charles III's first coin? Let us know in the comment section down below what you think. And don't worry, next video we're back with ancient coinage, I promise. This was just a cool topic I wanted to cover. So happy collecting, and I'll see you soon.